Greetings, everyone. Welcome back. I'm going to be demonstrating what I call the magic in quotation marks, of GIS. I'm going to be demonstrating a few things about what really the core functionality is about GIS that makes everything else possible. And what I want to show you is that this attribute information, this tabular data, is connected to the geometry that's displayed in the display area. Let's find a country. Let's find, doesn't matter which one. How about Spain here? I'm going to select Spain, and I'm going to click right over here on the row. Do you see how this row highlights in blue? I've selected that row now. I'm going to go back so I can look at the geometry. Take a look at that. Spain is now highlighted in blue. I selected attribute information. I selected Spain by its name in the attribute table just by going in there and clicking on it, and then Spain highlights in the display area. There's a connection, there's a link between the geometry and the tabular information. In order to clear my selection, I can do that a couple of different ways. I can click this here. This is clear selection in the table view, and then it's gone. It's gone from here, and it's gone from there. There's also a clear selection right up here, clear selected features, if you're in the geometry view. I can also go the other way. Let's say that I'm interested in knowing, well, I'm going to click over here to Saudi Arabia, but let's say I didn't know what country this was, and I want to click on Saudi Arabia, and I'm using this tool right up here. I'm using Select Features. Now I've turned the geometry blue. Now I'm going to go back to the attribute table, open attribute table, and if I scroll along the attribute table, I'm going to find that, well, yep, I've got one row selected, and it's Saudi Arabia. So, looks good. I can go both ways. I can select something from the data table and get its geometry. I can select something's geometry and get its data table information, its attribute information. Very powerful. It's a very simple concept. I'm going to clear this by using this button up here. This is a very, very simple concept, this tying attribute information to geometry and spatial relationships between features. But it ends up being very, very powerful, and it ends up being what everything else in GIS is based on. So let me show you a few things you can do with this basic principle. I want to know all of the countries in the world which have a population of 50 million or greater. At least according to the data set that I'm using right here. Let's say that I want to make a query about which countries have a population of greater than 50 million. You will notice in the attribute table, this is information that I have. I have got a column here called pop country, and that records the population of the country at least according to whatever year this is current for. And like I said, this is a bit older data. But I'd like to query this column and find out which countries have a population of 50 million or greater. In order to do that, I'm going to run a selection by attribute. This is attribute information, and so I'm going to run a selection by attribute to select all the countries which have a population of greater than 50 million, equal to or greater than 50 million. I go up to selection, and select by attribute. Again, you don't have to keep up with exactly what button I'm pressing, because if you go on and take a complete introduction to GIS course, this is something that we'll spend a lot of time on, how to do all of these different kinds of queries. This is just, again, for the sake of example and demonstration. So now I have this Select by Attributes dialog box open, where I can run an SQL query in order to find out which one of these countries has the population that I'm looking for. If you don't know SQL, that's all right. If you go on to an Introduction to GIS class, basic SQL skills are something that we go over. If you are interested in going further and actually becoming a GIS specialist or professional, then learning SQL will allow you to construct some very powerful queries, and you definitely want to have that as sort of a tool in your arsenal. But let's just do something really basic right here. I do want to select this country 04 file, and then it asked me, what would I like to do? I would like to create a new selection. You'll notice I have nothing selected right now, so I'm trying to create a new one. And then I'm going to go to what column I'd like to query, population, country. I double-clicked that, and you can see that it's actually going to help me build an SQL query down here. You can type out SQL if you know it, or you can use this SQL query builder here to help you make sure that you get the syntax right for the queries without actually having to type it yourself. And I will caution you that the computer is very temperamental about making sure that all of the commas and all of the quotation marks and so forth are in exactly the right place in order to successfully execute the query. So it's something you have to watch out for. So anyway, you can tell that I am now selecting from country 04, where information in the population country, I want to say greater than or equal to, and then I'm just going to type in the value here. I want 50 million. And then I'm going to hit OK. And when I do that, I now have selected every country in the world that has a population of 50 million or greater, at least according to this data set. I have the geometry selected, I queried the attribute table, I have the geometry selected, and then I will also show to you that if I open the attribute table, that I do have all of those selections made in the table as well. Little handy trick here, if I go down here, if I just want to see how many countries in the world happened, according to this data set, again, happen to have a population of greater than 50 million, it says that it selected 24 out of 250 possible selections. If I want to just see the ones that are selected, I can go right here and say Show Selected Records, and here we go. It got rid of the ones that were not selected, just for the purposes of display. It didn't do anything with the data. It just lets me very quickly get to just the ones that were selected. Then I can go back and see all of them. So by constructing that query and querying attribute information about all of these different countries, I am able to get this geographic representation of which ones have that attribute and which ones don't, and I could begin to see geographic relationships between these phenomena. I'm going to clear this selection. Now I want to execute a query based on the geometry that I have here. I want to query my data based on the spatial relationships that I have. This is a very powerful component of geographic information systems that basic tabular data, that relational databases don't have. In geographic information systems, we have this geometry here in order to work with. So let's say I'm going to go over here and I'm going to click Afghanistan so that I have it selected. Let's say that I'm interested in knowing all of the countries that border Afghanistan. I'd like to make this query. This isn't something that's stored in the attribute table. Instead, it's a characteristic that's based on the geographic relationship between the territory of Afghanistan and the territory of other countries. So I can find this out because I have all the geometry here displayed. So I want to select all of the countries that border Afghanistan. In order to do this, I'm also going to make a selection, but I'm going to make a selection by location. I want to make a selection based upon the geographic relationships between Afghanistan and other territories of other countries, not the attribute information. Here is my selection by location dialog box. This has a tremendous amount of power, and if you go on in GIS, learning all of the different spatial queries is an extremely important part of learning how to do GIS. But let me just show you this particular spatial query. So I would like to select features from the layer countries 04. I want to have one feature selected, as it says, and then spatial selection method for target layer in this drop-down list. You can see that I have a lot of different options for what kind of spatial relationship I'm querying for. If you look down here, I have this one that says touch the boundary of the source layer feature. That's what I want. I want to find all of the other territories that touch the boundary of Afghanistan's territory. So I'm going to click that and then say OK. Now you see that I have a new selection. I've selected things based on the geographic relationship that these countries have with Afghanistan. So I'm going to go back over to the attribute table, open attribute table. I'll take a look at just the ones I have selected. It says I have 7 selected. I'm going to click on the Show Selected Records. Here are all 7 that I have. Notice that I didn't tell it to deselect Afghanistan. So there are 6 countries that border Afghanistan, but it has 7 selected because Afghanistan is still selected. If I didn't want Afghanistan to be selected, I could right-click over here and say Unselect. Okay, there we go. Now I just have 6. six countries that border Afghanistan, and I could check out all of the attribute information that I had about them, or I can take a look at all of the geometry that I know about them as well, all of the geographic relationships. So I can query information according to their data tables, or I can query data according to their spatial relationships. And I've shown you both of those. And what makes this possible is that there is a link between the geometry and those entries in the data tables. You can go back and forth. Select stuff in the data table, instantly get the geometry. Select stuff in the geometry, instantly get the data. Going back and forth is very easy, and that link is very important. The final thing that I want to show you is that, of course, I can do combinations. What if I'm interested in knowing all of the countries that border Afghanistan that have a population of 50 million or greater? How would I do that? In that kind of combination query, I'm concerned with information about geographic relationships, and I'm interested in information about attribute information. So it's very good that geographic information software allows me to work with both. So I already have all of the countries that border Afghanistan selected. I've got those six. Now I want to find out, of those, which ones have a population of 50 million or greater. So in order to do that, I'm going to execute a selection by attribute. Here is what I want to do, though, this time. You'll notice that it's already saved the query from last time, but I want to change this option right here. I no longer want to create a new selection. I want to select from current selection. I have six selected. I'm interested in selecting from those all of the countries with a population of greater than 50 million. So that's the only thing that I'm changing here, and then I'm going to say apply. You'll notice there was a change. I'll say OK. So now when I go to my attribute table, you'll see that I only have three selected. I only have Iran, Pakistan, and China. Those are the three countries, at least according to this data set, that have a population of greater than 50 million and that border Afghanistan. So that, in a very basic nutshell, has not only shown you a couple of things about how to get started with data, but has also shown you the core component of GIS, as far as I'm concerned, this link between attribute information and geometry. And that allows us to construct a whole bunch of queries to find out all kinds of great information, and will ultimately allow us to conduct some very sophisticated analysis.